Tony Abbott is sticking by his claim that the Prime Minister is guilty of a low act for his comments over his visit to a troops in Afghanistan. But Julia Gillard says he's simply wrong.
Tony Abbott back in the country and refusing to shoot from the lip at the airport.
Now's not the time to say anything.
But action man Abbott was on the warpath in Afghanistan, firing off a salvo at Julia Gillard for what he described as a low act of bastardry, for briefing journalists that he had declined her offer to visit the troops together.
Sometimes Tony Abbott runs to harsh words before he's bothered to get the facts.
Fairfax journalist Phil Currie says the Gillard office was not the source of his original story.
I just won't cop any suggestion that I am indifferent to the fate of our troops.
Staying above the fray, Home Affairs Minister Brendan O'Connor farewelling 16 more Australian Federal Police heading for the war zone as mentors for the locals.
We are fully behind the mission in Afghanistan.
He says Australia would be prepared to consider sending more.
The coalition's economic credibility suffered collateral damage today with the leaking of correspondence between the Liberal and National Party federal directors and the accountancy firm that purportedly did an audit of pre-election costings.
The two-party directors accept that the work of HWK Howarth is not of an audit nature.
The work done by the accounting firm was an unprecedented level of scrutiny for any opposition in history.
Whatever the opposition says, the full extent of their deception has been made clear today.
Treasury found a $10 billion hole in the coalition's numbers. Paul Bongiorno, 10 News.